Well, yeah, on the Burtons are on Tyson's mother's side, and we go back with them a long time. When I was a kid, I used to be with their uncle, and he was a good fighting man. He's a Belfast fighter, old Hughie Burton. I've got good fond memories with him. So he was a good fighter as well. On our side, and they go back further than that. Then that's only where I can remember. But there's all fighting people, like you said. You got Jose Burton now. He's I think 7-8-0, isn't he? Young Zach, his brother Chasey, they're good fighting lads then. They've been in boxing gyms since they was no age. So they're doing well. And they're keeping the granddad and great uncle very proud, I would imagine, from up above. On our side, yeah, it goes back a long way. My granny on my grandmother's side, her brother was a professional fighter. He was a Belfast fighter as well, but he was also a pro fighter. And he'd done well. He had over 300 fights, he did. And he'd done very well. And he was known out throughout the gypsy community back then.
What was his name?
Well, I don't know. He's Ticker Gorman, he was.
Right.
Yeah. And then we had, then again, More recent, we had Bartholomew Bartley Gorman. You must have heard of his book, King of the Gypsies, and all this. There was him and his brother Sam. They could fight in the day as well. They're related on my father's side, and they done very well.
So Bartholomew's your uncle.
Yep.
Yeah.
He was a very good fighter in his day. Again, he was an athlete who boxed as well, and. He's a serious guy. He loved to fight. But I look up to the older people in the past who's now gone. God rest their soul. Because these would have a fight. There was no knives, there was no guns then. They'd have a fight, they'd have a sing as well. There was real good company. I'm fortunate enough when I was a young fella to be in the company of Bartley Gorman, to be in the company of old Hughie Burton and people like this, because there was exceptional characters. There was men's men. Old Hughie Burton would have he'd have it in his shed, and he'd have a rope. Just a rope for a ring with the old paving stones on the floor, and there'd be a hay and a horse chewing at it. That was his boxing thing. And his sparring partner was a fellow called Jock McAvoy, who's from here. He fought for a world title from Manchester here. All you bet was a serious man, he could fight. He'd do 25, 30 rounds of sparring per day. Tough as old leather boots. Yeah.
And you brought up around all that?
Brought up around it. I spent 3 years with the old man. Every morning, 5 o'clock. There'd be no lying in with him. He'd come and knock on your door at 4:30. He used to know where I'd sleep, and he used to whisper through the window. So he didn't knock my mother or father up. And he said to me after about 2 weeks, he said, "You've got something about you, lad," he said. He said, "Because look at all these others. Look, they're sick. They're like they've come down with malaria. I'll never forget it." He said, "But you," he said, "you keep getting up." He said, "Now I'm going to give you another test." Because he kept giving people tests until they all got sick and backed off and never bothered again. He was like that. And he said, "I shouldn't have to knock you up," he said. "You should be up and ready." So for 5 o'clock, I was up every morning. And we went everywhere together, getting straw for the horse, up and down. And I used to listen to this old man speak. And he spoke a lot of sense. So I was very proud of the old man, to be honest. I did like him, and same with old Bartley Gorman as well. There was good people, loved the sport of boxing. They loved fighting. It is a unique person who fights, steps in the ring, and learned good fond memories of him. So yeah, on all sides of the family, we've got fighting.
Was you always inspired then by them as young? Boxing, was it always something you aspire to do and to, you know, to follow in their footsteps?
Well, I don't know. You know, we was all, you know, me and my brother John. You know, I've got another brother as well. We always like little boys travelling up and down, because we obviously from travelling people, we were travelling from place to place. We'd always find the local gyms and leisure centres, you know, put the gloves on with the kids and start sparring with them. You know, we stopped in a place called Derbyshire growing up, and it was like there was a cricket field, and every Saturday and Sunday we'd go and have a fight with the local kids at the estate. You know,
they come and challenge you.
Black eyes, yeah, one thing or another. You know, this is it, you know, we'd be stripped off to the waist and having a fight. So that's the way our childhood was growing up. And, you know, and that's it really. And then when we got older, you know, me and my brother, I had an amateur fight, so did he. I had one pro fight, he carried on with these. I've got diverted in other directions. Had a few fights on the street for money and things like this. Got myself in trouble. That's me. You know, and, you know, but we've always, in our lives, wherever we was, even when I was in jail doing a big sentence, it was in the gym. There was boxing gloves on. The inmates, boxing with the inmates, fighting in the prison. It's just what you are. It's your DNA, isn't it? You can't change what you are, can you? You know, I remember I was in, so when I was doing my time, I was in heavy secure conditions. You know, it was in Cat A conditions, and they had to all be approved to come and see me. I remember we had some photos took, and these was only be babies. I don't know, I think there's a picture on them. I've seen it somewhere. He was about three or four, Huey, yeah? And I've got three boys. So my missus said, you know, these kids, you know, other people's telling them stories about you, you know, the fights you've had on the street and this and that, you know. And I've said to them, when I come up again, you'll take your shirt off and have a picture with them. So I've had to get special permission from the governor, yeah, so Z's could have a picture. Took. So the picture where he's got his hands up like this, yeah, it's in Franklin Prison, this, yeah, and I got special permission. And they took us round the back and they let them have a few pictures. So just things like that, you know, and, you know, I've got three sons and three daughters, and they can all handle themselves because I've always had them training. But you know who's got it and who hasn't. You know, and the little one, the youngest, he was always quiet. You know, but you can see sort of steely determination and toughness with him, you know. So, you know, we've been fortunate. You know, John, my brother, he's ended up with one son, who's Tyson. And I've ended up with one son myself, who's dedicated and love fighting. You know, so it's in the blood, you know, that's it. So, that, you know, it's just how it is. I come from a family of four brothers. One brother wasn't remotely interested, he hated trouble at all, you know, he couldn't stand it. He was quite quiet. And the three of us, you know, we'd love to have a fight. It's just, it's how your makeup is, isn't it, as you grow up, what you are.
And you and John turned pro, didn't you, as well?
Yeah.
You know, and yeah, a few fights. And where did you train when you first started on the pro?
We turned professional with a fella called Tommy Miller from Halifax. Old Tommy. He's a rum old fella, he was. Character as well. You know, there's way where you're going about the old-fashioned days, you know. I always refer back to the old days with boxing. Because fighting men was real fighting men back then. You know, so... So yeah, it was good. So yeah, we had Tommy Miller, and we trained with a fella called Bert Myers from Burnley. And he was a good trainer, Bert was. And we done a little bit in Liverpool with Franny Hands. I met Pat Brogan, Charlie Atkinson, them type of people. And yeah, that was about it really. So we was took up sparring to Leeds, you know, we done a fair bit of sparring with Crawford Ashley at the time. He was a phenomenal puncher, he was. I never forget him. He could punch. He was a good fighter as well. And there was another fella called Liam Coleman, something like this. I think he died in a car accident. And we used to spar with all kinds of people like this. Champs camp here. We went there and done some training with them there when Phil Martin was alive. So.